Welcome one and all, this is the Peace Dealer. And today I'm gonna talk about why I don't consider myself as a part of the spiritual community. It's something that every time is mentioned or said, I wince. Like I just instinctually don't consider myself a part of said community. I don't feel like I'm better than other people in the spiritual community. I just don't feel like the spiritual community really exists. So keep in mind, I'm saying why I don't feel a part of it, but this reflexively applies to you. You're not a part of a spiritual community as well. You are relatively, you are in a sense, and myself as well, but you're not. And you can take away spiritual and insert any word. The way I feel about being tied into a spiritual community is the way that I feel being tied into the black community. When anyone says the word black community, I flinch instinctually at a soul level. I think it's like, ew, or spiritual community. And that's because you're labeling people. You're placing labels on people to generalize a person's existence. I don't consider myself a black person. I consider myself me. I don't consider myself a spiritual person. I used to, when I was struggling with my identity, and I thought that what this was all about is about spirituality and light work. And as I've come to understand myself as an individual more, I feel like it's limiting to say that you're a part of a spiritual community. And the real reason why I don't consider myself part of a spiritual community or the spiritual community is indirectly it's a way to kind of tie people and put people in a box and to limit the essence of what we do, which is infinite and multidimensional in nature, and just say, oh, it's spiritual. And what happens is you start to stereotype people who are spiritual. You think, oh, well, this is the spiritual community. This is what they do. This is like the dark side of the age of Aquarius, or just like Aquarius energy or 11th house energy. Nothing wrong with Aquarius or Aquarius people, but this whole trend of like labeling people and putting people in the Asian community, a black community, a spiritual community, a scientific community. You're not really, I mean, these exist, so it's not happening because out of nowhere. So the whole term of it is not entirely wrong, but I've never considered myself a part of the spiritual community. I've never considered the videos that I do only for spiritual people. An atheist can watch my video, a Christian can watch my videos and disagree with them, but they can still watch and gain something from it, all right? A Buddhist can watch my videos, someone of any color, gender can watch my videos, and when you say that I'm a part of a spiritual community, or when you say that I'm a part of the spiritual community, I feel like it limits me. I feel like it limits you as well. As in, like, you can only share yourself with people who believe in what you believe, and that literally goes against the ethics and mechanics of everything we do to spread quote unquote light, dark, whatever you want to call it. A lot of these labels have hurt us more than helped us. And this is not specific to just spirituality, but everything. Even right now that I said specific to spirituality, what has hurt this quote unquote community so much is using the term spiritual and spirituality. Spirituality is not different from science. There's spirituality of everything. There's a science of everything. The science literally just means the knowledge of. So there's the knowledge of cards, there's the knowledge of physics, there's the knowledge of spirituality, right? Spirituality really just means doing something every day with commitment. Really, anything that you do every day is your spirituality. It's not about being religious and saying, I believe in this, I believe in that. Everything that you do every day to where your habits align with your beliefs is your spirituality. If you shoot up heroin every day and you don't show up and you're a douchebag to everyone around you, that's your spirituality. If you're a snob and you look up, if you look down on people and you preach a certain message but you live a different way, that's your spirituality. It's literally the perceptual axis. It's nothing that you can separate from anything else because it's a part of everything. People who think they're not spiritual, they're spiritual. They just don't understand the word. And can you blame them? Because the word has been so misconstrued. And this is how the dark forces work. They take amazing concepts and they confuse you to the point where you don't care anymore. A lot of people are being disinterested in astrology. They're being disinterested in cars because they look at the community. They look at people who are in quote unquote the community and they're like, I don't want to be like that person. I don't want to come across like this. And it just gives what we do a bad name and it shrouds it in illusion. And this is a ploy. This is not random. This is so mainstream television people, I can't believe I just said that, can basically quantify us, typecast us, and make us look like frauds and crazy people. And you can't really blame them because most of the people that they're profiling say, I'm a part of the community. Like they're not really wrong in doing what they're doing. So for those of you who've been kind of struggling to know how to identify with this, start with yourself. Don't let anybody label you. This is an issue that goes way beyond spirituality, right? People say the gay community, the LGBT community, the blind community, you know what I'm saying? Communities exist. So I'm not gonna say that the spiritual community doesn't exist. There's a community that exists with people who bring in their gifts and talents and preach whatever the fuck they want, okay? Some people don't even know what the hell they're talking about. But hey, they believe it, so it must be true. And this is really what just kind of blends lines and makes it hard for people to take what you or I do seriously. And this goes beyond spirituality, even in the scientific community. Quote unquote, they're going through this as well. That's all an illusion. There's the illusion of separation, but there's also the illusion of labels. And you personally are not a part of a community. We're all one. I don't see myself as a part of the spiritual community. I see myself as part of the human race. So there's really nothing that I can't take from other people. I don't see myself as separate from another community. Even though, once again, physically, you know, it is real. Like, there is a spiritual community that where there's a subcore where people just do cards or people just do astrology. I just think it's wrong to put it all under an umbrella. I think it's wrong to kind of limit yourself and say that you're a part of a community when you're so much greater than that. So those are my thoughts. This is very debatable. What I just told you right now could actually be easily refuted and debunked. I'm not trying to be right here, y'all. I'm trying to be real. So many people are trying to like push this agenda and say why they're right. I don't care if I'm right right now. I just want to let you know how I really feel. This is how I really feel about this. Don't ever say I'm part of the spiritual community. I'll take that as an insult. Don't ever say that I'm part of the black community. Because these are ways that people mean well, by the way, but other people can use that as a way to put others in a box and say, oh, if you're from this community, this is how you act. When every single one of you that's a part of this community is your own unique person. You bring your own flavor to the table, and unity is important. But when we start to exclude others because they don't believe the same stuff we do, we're doing it the wrong way. So those are my thoughts on that. I know a lot of you feel the same way, so comment your thoughts on this below too. And yeah, I would have talked a lot longer about this because I'm a Gemini and I like to hear myself talk, and the concept of just, you know, speaking a message that is succinct is foreign to me because I just need to blab like I'm doing right now. But my battery's about to die, so I don't have a choice. And until the next video. Main event, you the undercard. I'm big homie, little nigga, I done spun the yard. Gun to gun right now with any one of y'all. What up? Had to give him half of it, he ain't want it all. Nah, put a little weight on, I had to run it all. 40 milligram, old Panda, G74s, no fly zone. 4-5 chrome, yeah. Might get strangled tonight on the ride home. Yeah. Niggas hold grudges, I just hold my own. So many fake Dutches, I'm starting to buy cones. Yeah. Sold CDs, sold tapes, I sold vows. Niggas try to copy and paste my whole style. Yeah. When you know your man is telling, then go to trial. One is so stupid, the other is so foul. I was lucky to get my hand on the big banks, and I'm letting these niggas live, so they should give thanks. What? Shit! Yeah. D-Block. LOX.
Rick Don Don. I got him, my nigga.